printed the gray and the indigo together, indigo blue, and mixed that to make my nuthatch, which I put on top of a frame. Where's the board that goes in the back? Oh. I have that signed. I'll put that in there. And I'm gonna make an egg and put it right here and paint it. And that's what's gonna go in there. So this bird, so anyway, let's not get off track. So to make these tail feathers is I added green and a little bit of black on top of what I made for the nuthatch. So I kept my scrap pieces and I got this. And so I started to put them on. I'm gonna put this last piece on. Remember, I only care how it looks like from this angle. So I put those on. I don't want them too far spread apart. Right. And so that's how that would look from that angle. Okay, so here you can see you don't want it too thin. You don't want it too thick either. Knit this in a little more. Now look, took the beak down a little bit. What I would do now is maybe put some gloss on there, which I have. So, make sure this stays like it is. Now you could make these out of felt too if you wanted to. And so I have this gloss, little gloss varnish. I'll give it a little shimmer. That's all you need is a drop. I'm gonna put it on there. See that piece of wool? Of course, that'll dry clear. Try not to touch your wool. There we go. I'm gonna finish up this part. I got my leftover from my other mixture. Just got this green speck in here. I don't think I want that. little V-neck maybe. See that little dark piece right there? I'll make that go on a scallop. I can add a few more. I didn't mix that quite enough. Touch your beak. It's still wet. Pull it out. His feet right about there. Make them not reticulated but ribbed. See, let me put that in there. You don't want to poke your bird flat. Put one more. Three is good. See how that poked in? So, I'm gonna take my pull your hairs out white needle and re-fluff that up. And then I can redo it. Remember, we want to keep our curve, right? I suppose I'm going to have to put another one in. Earthquake. I'm pushing it over this way. Okay, so I'm going to put another one right there. I don't think I'm gonna do those ribs though. Who cares? Does anybody care about those? I'm not even sure if you're gonna see this one. So much. Okay. Nice. My nail as a stop guard. It's my magic thumbnail. It takes anything off. Paint, varnish, plant residue. Whatever. So maybe you might see it in the, especially if it's curved. It's curved. Cute little birdie. So the advantage of felt is it stays stiffer than doing that, but this way you can practically get any color you want. Up this little bird here in a minute. I gotta do his ruby throat. I'm gonna pick the colors for that. And that will be another part to our hummingbird real-time, realistic hummingbird.